You sent me a great list. Let's knock down some of those bullet points and I'll read them and you explain what they mean in terms of
Okay.
being a good sports parent. The first one you had, don't confuse, defuse.
One of the things that I often did when my son was playing youth sports, and actually still do it as a high school athlete, is if he scores a goal, that was my parenting. And if he turns the puck over, that's my wife's parenting. Okay. Now, that's funny, right? And my wife takes it with a grain of salt. But here's the whole idea, okay, behind that. My son's play is not a direct reflection of who I am as a parent, one way or another. So when I say don't confuse, defuse, what I mean is don't confuse your effectiveness or your relationship with your child, with their performance in sports, academics, or anything, actually, and diffuse it by reminding yourself that their path, their journey, their skills, their
I can look at
performance
the
is their
graphics.
own.
Number two, have a plan. I like that, responding to the ups and downs and going in with a plan.
Well, I can think of numerous times in, you know, games that were important to our team where I knew that there was likely to be a lot of emotional chart or a lot of emotion involved in it, right? And so I can also think of times where we played certain opponents based on watching their behavior, the parents' behavior in other tournament games, that it's also likely to be a highly charged environment, right? So what in those situations, I prepared myself and determined and made a determination of how I wanted to react to that and what I wanted to do and how I was going to keep my composure. Sometimes it was bite my tongue. Sometimes it was telling my wife to pinch me on the arm. Okay. Sometimes it was telling another dad that I was with, hey, you know, let's help to keep each other composed, right? Or kind of like calm each other down.
Be aware.
So that means, like, what is it that, like, as you're making that determination, right? Be aware of your surroundings, your environment, your emotional and mental state, so that you have the appropriate resources. Because I can tell you, like, if I've had a really long week, or I haven't gotten enough sleep, or there's been a stressful life event that's happened in family or with work, that I may have a little less emotional capacity in those scenarios, right? So
Right.
that means my preparation and my self-care has to be better, right? And
Right.
what it means is being aware of, and also being aware of what might trigger you.
Determined.
Like, be determined and figure out who you want to be in that environment. And then act accordingly. Because what often happens is if we're not determined to live according to those values, we're much more likely to forget about them.
Don't fall into the winning and losing trap.
If someone's behaving in an out of control way and you don't like it, a lot, what often happens to a lot of people is they get stuck in the trap of having to win or lose the argument with that other person, whether it's on their own team or someone else.
Don't get kicked out. You know, sounds super simple, but like you say, if that happens, it's bad on any number of levels.
That's embarrassing for a kid when that happens, because everyone can see it. And there also may be consequences in terms of like how bad it is. You may have to go to a hearing. You may get suspended. If you do it enough, your child may not be allowed to participate. And there are some people who get kicked out for like in an entire season,
right,
because of their behavior. So just don't. And really, there's nothing that happens in any sporting event that's worth getting asked to be removed, because essentially what's happening when you get kicked out is the people around you are saying, we don't feel safe around you.
Finally, you said be smart, but I put in bold, watch the cocktails.
You got an hour or hour and a half, the older they get,
right,
you know, to go gather as a community. I think it's a really important part, actually, of having a great parent group, right?
Right.
Because that's how you build community.
Okay.
At the same time, if you don't have the ability to recognize when you've gone too far, many times what I have seen is the things that end up causing problems, or this happens a lot in our culture in general, the things that fuel that is too much alcohol. And so what you just want to be mindful of is how much of that, and where is your level of influence over that? And to not let it get out of control.